Yeah. He's a pickleball player. I know that.
Jackson, for you, like, I always like representing the school, knowing that your dad, of course, is on the staff, you know, Coach Will Cox forever, and his team. You're trying to have a couple of
teams. It's an honor to be here. It's been a great event. A lot more topic than I'm used to. But yeah, it's been great.
Knowing all the interviews I do with your dad, I can tell that in the family you'd rather just have action more than words. But we had a great conversation yesterday before we opened it up to questions from the media. I just want you to explain kind of your decision and coming back and playing in the league. Because, you know, it sounds like it was after the season and you sort of said another year would add another year to help build the culture and get this team back on track.
Yeah, my thought process, you know, the first thing I thought of is I'm not going to rush to be done playing college football. I really enjoy playing college football. And then I really enjoy, you know, my the setup at Cal. I think it's a really unique situation. I really enjoy the team. I enjoy the guys in the locker room. I enjoy the culture. And then the opportunity to play for, you know, your dad is pretty rare. And so I want to make the most of that opportunity. And I think as far as I think my fit in the scheme, I think I fit well in that scheme. I think I learned a ton in 1 year and developed a ton as a player and as a person in 1 year, so I was excited to come back and do it again.
Okay, we'll go ahead and open up questions now to the media. If you have a question, please raise your hand. We'll bring you over your question. Bring over the microphone. We'll start here in the third row on the left.
Hey, Tyler Budge, CF Budge. You guys lost 5 games by 1 score last year. Is that something that is like motivational, knowing how quickly things are flipping, or how are you guys kind of handling that a lot?
Yeah, I think we've talked about it for a few years now, that we're close, and I think we're kind of tired of just being close. And so we've set a culture this offseason that we're going to finish things, we're going to do things the hard way, and we're going to, you know, make sure that we win those close games and they go in our favor this year. So, yeah, just setting that culture from the very beginning this winter, and I think it's gone well this summer. Now we got to go into camp with that same mentality so that these games go our way.
Next question is back row on the right, Jim. Jim, the GoParentsCenter.com. You guys are 6-year veterans, and you're seeing a lot of new guys that are being part of the team right now, whether they be freshmen or portal transfer guys. How seamless has that transition been? Does the culture of the team help integrate these guys a lot faster than you typically see?
Yeah, I think it's been, if you told me in the winter that we're going to have half the roster be new guys, I would have been worried. But how it's played out, I think it's been the guys that we have new, they've done a fantastic job of buying into the culture. They've all come in, they've worked their tails off, and they're all hard workers and good teammates, and I think that's credit to the coaching staff. I think they chose guys that they knew would fit in to the culture that we built at Cal. So it's really been... It's been, I think, as seamless as you can have it for having 50 new guys. But I think fall camp is going to be a big... I think fall camp is going to help us just gel even more, and I'm excited for it.
Everybody always throws around the word culture. I'm curious how you both would describe it.
Yeah, I think it's a unique culture. We have a really good locker room of guys who want to be really good on the football field, but also want to be good at life. And I think that breeds competition in everything we do, which is really fun. And we just have a bunch of guys who really care about each other, and they've come in and like Jackson said, like meshing together. It's an opportunity to have 50 new friends, as I say. So yeah, just coming together as best as possible. And yeah, the coaching staff has done a great job recruiting guys that really fit with that culture.
We talked to Coach about the goal that is connected we put on last weekend. Can you walk us through how that came together? Because we saw some of the video, it looks amazing. How did you have that idea?
Yeah, so it was something I'd done in high school, working with that community. And so I knew if I was going to come back for a 6-year, I had to do something beyond myself. I had a little more time, a little less class. So it was a really cool opportunity to work with kids with disabilities. Give them a voice. Football can be exclusive at times, so I just wanted to make it more inclusive for everybody. And with the Cameron Institute at Cal, Student Athlete Development, they were huge in helping me put it on. And that's why I love Cal. It's more than just football for us. So Had an amazing event last Saturday, and super grateful for all the kiddos who came out. I think they had a great time, and had over 30 volunteers from our team, which was just incredible for college guys to donate 3 hours of their time. So really special event, and hope we can continue to hold monies for years and years to come.
Any stories pop out of somebody afterwards coming up to you and say, hey?
Yeah, I had a kid say, like, I don't want to leave. And so that was maybe the cutest thing that a kid's ever said to me. So I think he had a good time, and I hope most of the kids felt that way.
I mean, that's kind of what you guys said, too.
Exactly, I'm never leaving.
Go ahead.
Our next question comes from the front left here.
What's the biggest lesson you've learned, good or bad, in your time at Cal? And how does it feel getting one last shot at Stanford?
Sorry, what was the last part of that question?
How does it feel getting one last shot at Stanford this year?
Oh, yeah.
I'll answer the first part. Yeah. I think the biggest thing you learn over your years is you can't be what somebody else wants you to be. You have to be your own player, and especially as a young guy, you come in, there's a lot of great leaders on the team, and you want to mimic them, but you also have to have your own flair on it. So over the years, I've kind of come into myself, who I want to be as a leader and as a person, and hopefully I've achieved being a unique individual, a unique leader on the team.
And then for the second part of that, I'm really happy I'll get another chance to play in the big game. Last year was a fun one, it was my first one. And so I was able to learn all the history behind that game. And Memorial Stadium was sold out, it was rocking. So it'll be fun to see what the big game looks like at a different venue. And that was a really fun game. It was entertaining, down to the wire. And I'm excited to get another one, yeah.
Next question is from the back right. Kevin Turner, Sun Devil Radio Network. Gentlemen, with the absence now of the Warriors departing the neighborhood and the A's coming to Vegas, the Raiders obviously here, you guys feel like there's a window of opportunity to regain the city and sell some more season tickets and fill up Strawberry Canyon once again and own that city?
Yeah, for sure. We want to make Cal football the team of the East Bay. And so we definitely have the opportunity this season, especially coming out with a home opener like Auburn is a really exciting opportunity. When we win games, people will show up. So our goal is to just win as many games as possible and get that stadium rocking.
Jackson, you were very helpful in that answer about getting another shot at Stanford. You didn't mention the play that you had, but we'll go down in Cal football to allow you guys to win that game. Can you walk me through what you remember about that play and what that moment was like for you?
Yeah, I remember it being one of the weirdest plays I've ever been a part of. It was they were Wildcat quarterback, took the snap and just started running the ball, and then Daniel Scott wrapped him up, made a great play, forced the ball out, and Jeremiah Irby, our freshman corner, picked it up and started running down the sidelines, and the quarterback made an incredible play. It really is almost unfortunate for him because he made an incredible effort. Popped the ball back out, and I was following Irby because I thought I was going to run with him in the end zone, and it just popped out right in front of me, picked it up, and then all I did was not mess it up. So I just picked up and ran and scored, and the whole time I remember thinking, like, this is going to get called back. Like, there's no way this is actually going to count just because of how weird the play was. But, yeah, it was pretty fun.
And that was your first touchdown since?
Freshman year of high school. Yeah, I think we talked about this yesterday. My high school coach, I played tight end in high school, and he always had a joke that I was allergic to the end zone because I got tapped on the one line a few times in high school, and so he was the first person I texted after the game. One of the most scored a touchdown.
I mean, yeah. We talked about close games a year ago and not being on the winning side. Specifically, what are you doing? What is the team talking about? What are the actions?
Yeah, I think the big thing we're doing right now is our conditioning, our coach calls it 4 quarters. So, you got to be mentally locked in all 4 quarters. And, they're strict on us. If we're not finishing from the line, if we're not, with the team counting off, they'll send it back. So, I think it's being more disciplined and things like that. And you never know what rep is going to happen in the game. So just as many player-run practices as we can have, as much team dinners as we can have, just to make sure that when we're ready and those moments come, we're locked in and we can trust the guy next to us.
You guys both went through spring ball. You're part of the offense. You have to go against the offense. When you got into player-run practices this offseason, what have you noticed about that group? You got a quarterback and Sam Jackson, presumably. New style, new scheme, etc. Here's both of your takes on that side of the ball.
Yeah, just from a defensive perspective, it's completely different, and it really changes how you play defense. You know, we're gonna play third down different. They do a good job of running problem plays, and they make sure to put at least one defender in conflict at any play. You never know when you're gonna be that defender, so it keeps you on your toes. And then with a quarterback that can run the ball, that adds a whole other layer of difficulty in trying to stop it. And it seems like, you know, I think Matthew can talk about this, but it seems like they picked it up well. I think the offensive staff has done a good job installing it. But it was challenging right out of the gate.
Yeah, it's been fun. Coach Powell came in, a lot of energy. I think all of us remember watching Davis Webb and the boys back then tearing it up. So, yeah, we were real excited to get into it. And it's just fun to play fast, play fearless. We do what we do, and we do it well. And as an O-line, I can really speak to just the fact that we can play open and free. We're not worrying so much. And he lets us play more strengths, which is really important.
There's so many games that you can look on your schedule that are going to be exciting. You mentioned the home opener against Auburn. Obviously, that one's circled. But for you, you get to go back to Seattle, because where you started your collegiate career with the Washington Huskies. Have you thought much, and we talked about it again, have you thought much about what that emotion is going to be like being back at home?
Yeah, I'm not typically a super emotional guy, so I'm sure it'll feel a little different than every other game. You know, every game is important. Every game is, you got to take it really serious. But when you look at the schedule, there's a couple logos that stick out a little more than others. So it'll be special. It'll be interesting. You know, I have a lot of practice in that stadium, a lot of games in that stadium. So it'll be, you know, it's a cool venue. They do a good job. The fans, they get it loud, and so it's a fun place to play. So I'm excited to go back and have a fun game.
Maybe another lightning game. From
2:30 a.m.
finisher, so
I don't want that again.
Well, we were also reminiscing, and we'll let you guys go in 1 minute, but remember when you played Cal and you were on the other side and you made that game stop and play, and called that afterwards, and that conversation didn't last too long?
Yeah, I before every Cal UW game, when I was at UW, there was you beat before the game, they move on, you need to move our calling plays or something, or even tackles. And then after the game, one of us is always long out, so the conversation is pretty short. And then, so I was on that last play, the last series that you done, I really get excited. And I went up to my dad, and I'm like, I think I might have made that play. I think I was on that play. And he was like, oh, good job, because he was just super upset about losing the game.
Well, I am glad that now, whatever you're going to be playing, it's both of you who are going to be happy.
Yes.
Thanks so much, you guys, for your time today. Best of luck this season. We look forward to watching the Bears.
Thank you, guys.
Go Bears. Thanks for having us. Go Bears.